I like to say Okolea was formed in order to make access to finance, to actually deepen financial inclusion, ensure that anybody in this country can be able to access credit, regardless of their social or economic background. We wanted to create a company that can actually guarantee universal loan access, that so long as you download our app, you register, you are guaranteed of getting a loan, and then you can be able to build a limit over time. The idea was, if we can be able to do that, even the guys who couldn't get a loan because of being in the CRB can be able to get loans, then we can be able to share that positive data with CRBs. They can be able even to get credit elsewhere. In a nutshell, that is it. So we started the company in 2016. We started actively lending somewhere in February 2017 or so. We have close to 90,000 registered customers, servicing around 40,000 active customers who are borrowing from us every day. On a given month, we're doing close to 45,000 to 50,000 loans in any given month, and we are looking to grow our customer base to over 500,000 registered customers at the end of the year, and close to 250,000 active customers by end of this year. That should translate to over, say, 300,000 to 350,000 loans per month by end of the year. Since we ourselves found it very difficult to secure the credit we needed to fund this business, we decided to finance the business ourselves through the shareholders and several other investors who believed that every individual in this country deserves to get a loan. So we got a lot of commitments from people who had a bit of money here and there, and they gave us the money so that we can be able to actualize our bigger vision, which is ensuring that even the guy in the smallest village in any part of this country is able to access credit for his emergency needs, for his school fees, for his food, and mostly, most importantly, to start and grow their own small businesses. Yes. Well, let me start by acknowledging, yes, there's a gap. Even big institutions like us still find it very difficult to access the capital from big banks, as I mentioned. So you can imagine smaller startups that are trying to access even the basic funding. So there is a gap. Number two, if you try to get money from a bank, it's very cumbersome. It takes a long time. So for instance, if your child is sick at this particular moment, you need to get money in the next few minutes to rush that child to the hospital. If you walk to a bank, then they start giving you papers to sign, start asking you about collateral. You have to take your title deed, you have to take your logbook. It takes time, probably minimum one day, and your child is sick right now. So the gap or the area that we serve means that we can be able to offer that credit to in less than 2 minutes. By the time a customer registers, our app is assessed and borrows money, which is instantly credited to their M-Pesa record. It takes like less than 3 minutes. You can actually be inside a taxi taking a child to hospital, and just like that, you get your M-Pesa. And you're able to repay the loan in the agreed timeline, which is mostly 1 month. So, yes, so the companies that are coming into this space are coming because they notice there's a gap, and business people like to come in where there's an opportunity. But all I can say is, in as much as there are many players that are coming in, there are very few players like ourselves and others, another few others that are actually doing it the right way. Others just bring substandard products into the market. Others are fraudsters who will go and come up with very basic apps, put it out there, charge people so-called registration fees, take your money, and they now don't actually give you any loans. So we have to tell customers to beware of companies that are purporting to be players in our industry. Let people vet these companies very well. I'm not saying they should not actually go to these companies. I'm just saying let them do due diligence so that they don't get conned their hard-earned money. So, yes, the opportunity is there. There's a small clique or a small segment that refuses to pay their loan. I use the term refuse purposely because if you look at some of the guys who are refusing to pay loans of, say, 300, 500, or 1,000, most of them are employed. You look at their M-Pesa data and even other CRB data, and you find that these people are fully capable of servicing these loans. They simply refuse to honor their debt obligation. But in terms of percentages, I would say that our non-performing loans based on the number of returning customers is around 8%. So you have 92% of our customer base actually coming back every single time and servicing their loans. We cannot fail to abide to our commitments to give loans to every Kenyan simply because of 7% of Kenyans who are not honoring their debt obligation, yes. So we'll continue to offer loans to everybody. There are those who have asked us how can you be able to guarantee a loan to every single person? Because you look at the so-called market leaders in the market, for every 6-7 people who actually register in those apps, maybe one person gets a loan. The other 5 people are denied loans. They are denied loans because of CRB. They are denied loans because these companies purport to have very good evaluation methodology that tell them whether this person can give, can service a loan or not. We say it is not possible. Our commitment is give every person a chance, give them a small loan, let them service that loan, then continue to give them bigger, more customized limits and interest as time goes by. So yes, it's time the country, both the banks, both the fintech companies, embrace the concept of giving a loan to every single person. It shouldn't actually be an option. It should be a right, like every other right, that we need to give access to finance to every single Kenyan without discrimination based on tribe, without discrimination based on your economics, without discrimination based on social standing in our country, yes. Corporates will always be resistant to change. Change is not good for the big companies. Big companies like the status quo because it suits them. Because let me tell you something, Kangethe. When you keep borrowing the same 2,000 for 2 years, every time you go to the system, you borrow 2K, you pay. You borrow another 2,000, you pay. 2 years, you are still borrowing 2,000 and repaying. So who is benefiting? The company is very happy. It is getting, even I say at whatever rate, at X rate. They are getting their interest every single time without exposing themselves to more limit. But are they giving you, Kangethe, the consumer, a benefit? So the corporates will always be resistant to change. What I don't get is these big corporates, and we know them, they have huge resources. They have massive access to data. Why are they not using this data to come up with a system that is able to offer you the loan that you need based on the problem that you have? Why are they not doing that? Because such a system may not be aligned to their focus on the bottom line, because it means taking bigger risk on the consumer. Yeah. It takes believing more on the consumer. So what do they need to do so when they're already making tens of billions under the current lazy system? I don't think they are going to do it.